Well, I'm Spencer.
JD.
I'm Logan.
This is the Itchinites podcast number 80?
Yeah, I think it's 80.
Number 80.
That'll get retroactively fixed.
Yeah.
It's like, it's 79. Our mouths are cut out.
Yeah. I have to go now.
My planet needs me.
And we talk about video games, video game news, and just what's up, you know?
Yeah.
Before we talk about some of the random splattering of news, which I have a little bit. Rosie, what games have you been playing this week?
I've been playing League of Legends and Overwatch. And that's about it. And a little bit of Dragon Quest VIII. Less than I hope.
Yeah.
What about you, JD?
Resident Evil, Overwatch on PC and on console. A little bit of Street Fighter. And... am I playing something else? That's it. All right, on to the news.
Yeah, on to the
on
news.
On to the news.
So, what's going
to
go
on? On to the news. What have you been playing, whatever.
Pac-Man 2. It's not very good.
Hold on. Quick question. Did you beat something else?
Did I beat something else?
Yeah. Did you beat Dragon Quest?
A little bit.
No, I have not beaten Dragon Quest.
And what the hell are you doing playing another game?
I was.
What do you think you're doing here?
I played Pac-Man 2 because we're playing it with the Turbo Zone. It's another YouTube channel. You should check them out. They do reviews and mostly reviews.
Mm.
But yeah, I played that game so I could play it with him. It's very short. It's like a 2-hour game. It is not very good.
2 hours that could have went to
The 80-hour game of Dragon Quest.
Yes, you gotta start somewhere,
dude. That game, I'm stuck.
How are you stuck?
There's a part. I don't know if you're where I am, but there's a part where the dog escapes. And I just don't know where he went.
All right, well, just game AQs with them, dude.
I might have to. We'll see. I was hoping not to do that with this one, but we'll see.
Does your party not tell you? Like, I just talked to the party. You usually tell me what to do.
Are you past that part?
No, not yet. Sorry.
Okay, because, yeah, I consult, but they're kind of like...
they kind of like...
I wouldn't go here. And it's like, okay. And then I go to a different place, and I'm like, we've already been here.
What are you even doing here?
Yeah.
Idiot.
Don't you know what to do? So yeah, it's a harder game at this point, but it's okay. I still haven't wiped.
Yeah.
Avoided that.
That's good.
Are you guys ready to tackle some news?
No.
Ah!
Let's go.
Wii U production has ended in Japan, officially.
Aw, man.
Wii U it all along.
That's good, JD.
No problem.
That was good.
You really can't buy a comedy like this.
Yeah, I wish you could. I wish you could. But yeah, Wii U apparently is done. It's still supposedly... there's still manufacturing over in America, but I don't imagine that'll last much longer. I can't fathom it's more popular in America than it is in Japan.
Oh, would you be surprised?
I might be, but it's not very popular anywhere, so it couldn't be that.
It's like if you win, you still lost.
Right, right. So, that's what it is. But expect that to just die pretty soon, especially with the Switch coming out.
True.
Can't imagine that's a big deal.
True.
Have you played or have you heard of the new Conan Exiles game?
Yeah.
I'm sure that's come up.
Yeah.
I saw the video.
Would you be a 9 or a 10?
It was just blowing in the wind. There's a fighting scratch.
In case you haven't heard, Conan Exiles is a new Conan game, obviously. And the character creator gives you a little bit of freedom in how you make your character. Specifically, your genitalia. Yeah.
Oh, the video's so good. God, that dick is too big. I am a barbarian, as you are well aware. Dick flapping in the wind.
Yeah, it's got all kinds of physics and a slider to make sure that you are as well endowed as you could possibly imagine.
You see how he's cleaning his hands in this?
Yeah, after this one.
Yeah, no, that shit's fucking hilarious. November, they were like, it has a dick slider. I'm like, I think
finally! Well, the game I wanted!
Some games have had, like, packaging things where you can kind of make the package bigger. Right. But it's so great. This is just—it's just a fucking dick. Yeah. The physics are all fucked.
Yeah, yeah.
Just like
my dick is in a leaf. Okay.
Dead alive. Yeah, right.
The first Dead or Alive, it was just up and down motions for breast physics. But God, were they sensitive? Be like, psh, dun, 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 and you're like, what the fuck? So yeah, that's hilarious.
It's pretty great.
I love it.
They need to do this more
for equality in video games.
For the females, though. More so. I know they sort of do it, but they need to do it more.
What are you talking about?
For the females.
What about them?
So they can have, like, bigger vaginas. What?
More layers.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
A little bit of a...
like a roast beef
prolapsed slider. Vagina.
Yeah, and it's like, you can just make it flap a little bit more.
You can flap a little bit more. Like, in the stretching wind, it out. In the wind. Vagina physics need to be scripted, of course. I feel sorry for the guy that had to be like, yeah, I'll randomly generate all the dicks.
I want to see the boardroom meeting where they're talking like, so how do we make this?
So get this right.
Yeah.
What if we, because Conan kind of, you know, has a package, make the dick bigger, like a dick slider.
Yeah.
wait, what? Like we're going to get like a dick meter and we can make it longer. Yeah. All right. Keep talking.
And then I bet they did it. And it's just this big, like, log that just hangs on the side. And they're like, that doesn't look real at all. Like, how do we fix this? Physics.
Right.
We need more physics.
All the physics.
Yeah. I'm sure the game's great. I don't know.
What's going to sell the game, folks? I'll tell you what. He pulls down a thing. Dicks.
No. He doesn't pull. He pulls down
courageously.
His
dicks. Courageously just pulls down his pants.
See how dick? Dick my dick is.
Yeah, yeah.
See how big my dick is? Don't you want this big dick? You can have this big dick, yeah. Conan.
Yeah.
We have dick sliders now.
Yeah.
How would anyone have like a two? Okay, I can understand some people have like 2-inch like dicks or whatever because they want to be funny or whatever. They're like, I am a murderer!
It's got 2 inches. It's just like yeah, little just... things. Oh, man. Mm-mm. Conan.
You know people are going to pick it up just because of that now.
Oh, yeah. It's going to be a huge internet thing.
Yeah.
That's brilliant. I wonder
where the dick's at?
Are you going to be able to show that on YouTube? You would, right? You sure?
Dude, it's the same thing with
Russ.
Ark.
Ark too? I didn't know that.
I think Ark has nudity in it.
And you can't show it on YouTube?
Yeah. There's another game. There was a horror game. There's a horror game. I forgot what it's called. But there was like some demon that had a bunch of tits or something like that.
Mm.
Same thing.
Horror game.
Yeah. PewDiePie played
it. What about Dante Inferno?
I think he's played that game too.
No. I mean, was that censored? Because you know that part with the lady.
Yeah. Well, also Lucifer. Lucifer's giant dick is hanging around when he fights you.
Oh, really? I never noticed.
I didn't see it. I just know because Troy told me. He goes, he's fucking naked, dude.
No, I beat the game.
Just like when Diablo, in the first Diablo, Diablo's fucking giant-ass butt cheeks is just bouncing around when he's chasing the fucking math.
Come here, you. Also, you just see what you're making like, that ass.
So, yeah. Dick sliders. The future.
The future
just waiting for Japan to get on board.
Yeah, yeah.
They'll really run with it.
Right.
They'll have armor that protects just the dick.
Yeah.
It'll be the equivalent of... I sent you guys that picture, right?
No. Which one?
Forever goes... Oh, hold on. Let me see if I can find it. Oh, God. It's fucking awesome. It's a picture of the equivalent of a male character being treated the same as a female.
Oh, yeah. I don't think I've seen that before.
No.
Just adjust like
me. What the heck? Oh, my God.
Yep. That's a dick.
Jeez Louise.
I think that's, like, what you put on the turkeys, like, feet. If you put it in the oven or something, you know what I'm talking about?
No. The drum legs. I know what you're talking about.
The drum legs, yeah.
That's a decoration.
That guy's a 11 on that slider.
I don't need to identify in this game.
Right. Yeah.
Anyway.
So that's pretty wild.
Yeah.
Okay, some other news. Resident Evil 7 has officially been hacked.
What?
Yeah.
There's a hacked version of it you can download.
Mm-hmm.
Which is the interesting part is that it's using the same program that other companies have been using.
It's like that's something.
Yeah, that's slowly becoming more and more easy to hack. And other games that were using it that recently were hacked, which is kind of ironic, are Watch Dogs 2 and Deus Ex Mankind Divided.
Machina.
So, sorry. Maybe I misheard you. What does the hack version do?
No, it's the game.
It's like, yeah.
Oh. They just, oh.
You can just pirate it now.
Okay, great.
It's the proper terminology.
Yeah, so...
That sucks. I hate that.
The thing that people have been using is now becoming easier and easier to hack, so expect some kind of change on that in the future.
I think these are the same guys that couldn't hack Just Cause 3. I think they had the same anti-pirating software, mm-hmm. and they couldn't hack it for months. They were about to give up.
The thing is, I admire the guys who first hack it, because it's just kind of like usually a test, you know what I mean? Like, mm-hmm. I can do this. Let's see. But the people who just, like, you know, like, finally someone's hacked it, now I can get it for free and play it. It's like, I kind of have no respect for those kind of people, because, like, just pay for the game if you know you want to play it. You know what I mean? I believe in supporting the companies for games you want to play. You know what I mean?
Yeah, you know, I got in not an argument, that wouldn't be the right way to describe it, but I did a video with TurboZone and Majority on Sunday? One of those days.
Just a day.
A day. And we were discussing digital versus physical copies of games.
Okay.
And I was explaining to them how used games was really hurting people. Like, the people that make the game. Because they don't get any money for it.
Sure.
And they're like, well, I mean, this goes on a little bit in other things. But they're like, well, they wouldn't have bought it if it was... They wouldn't have bought it new anyway. And it's like, well, not... That doesn't really work that way because of expectations, yada yada. But we got to the point where we're talking about how it's good for people to pay for the game so that the people that made the game get money for it.
True.
And that concept is, like, totally missing from a lot of media now. Like, movies, music, and that. And video games, unfortunately, don't have concerts. You can't have, like, a concert to support the people that made...
What's E3?
Yeah. So like, music, yeah, they don't necessarily always make money now on the music, but they can have a concert and sell out stadiums. Movies, they have theaters. Like, you have to go see it in the theater to see it. Video games don't really have, like, a guaranteed source of income.
Right.
And so when you do this, it really does hurt it. And, like, indie games get it the worst, because if you just pirate an indie game, that's, like, all the money they have.
Right. It's usually like 10...
Damn it!
The thing about indie games, they're not ever like $60. They're kind of always reasonable. You know what I mean?
See, there's a problem with indie games as opposed to with standalone like titles or whatever the case is. Especially depending on who actually makes the indie game. If you get an indie game that's like $10.
Right.
Say it's a perfect product.
Good game.
It doesn't really mess up.
I like it.
You get a game, and then it has a lot of indie games will... Like, because there's not a... AAA games would be like 60 is the highest you can go.
Yeah.
For just the game itself. Or AAA. Yeah, we'll talk about that. But when it comes to indie games, you're going... I'm selling mine for 15. I'm selling mine for 10. You get two different products
right. For
that. Undertale was how much when you bought it?
10.
10. I think I got Thomas Was Alone for 15. It's about blocks jumping around. I will always bring that up because it's a shit game. So,
it's a mixed bag.
It's a mixed bag, is what I'm saying. You might end up getting something really great, like Undertale, and being like, "Damn, she was hot." Or you might get something going, "Damn, I wasted fucking $15."
I know, but here's the thing about that though. Could you have done a little bit of research on the game? You know what I mean? Like, just like
I like can, but you can never research how much you're gonna enjoy a game.
If you know yourself,
you can't.
With some indie games, I feel like if you do even a little bit of research,
you're ruining
like most of the game. Especially because some indie games are like 2 hours long. Like Beyond Eyes,
It's
2 hours long. Me watching 15 minutes of it is like a chunk of the game.
And here's the other thing to consider. When I got Resident Evil 7, I was expecting it to be okay. I wasn't even all that hyped for it. Turns out it's my favorite Resident Evil. You can't gauge it until you actually play it. That's why we always enforce the... beat it first and then you can review it.
Yeah, but...
Because then you can kind of gauge, hey, did I enjoy it? Get a better idea of it.
Yeah, but at the same time, there's always that aspect of looking at the game and just knowing, like, this isn't my type of tea, just from the get-go. You know what I mean?
I don't even play racing games, and I'm excited for the next Need for Speed.
Yeah, you like, oh, you are.
I'm Need for Speed, I'll probably always fall back on them. Sports games, if another freaking NBA Street comes out, you know I'm there.
I just want a new Midnight Club when it comes to racing games. That's the, one, the only thing I'm
Rockstar doesn't seem interested in that at all.
I know. Mm-hmm. That's what I'm saying. But
they're all about really just palette swapping at this point. We're taking it to the Westerns. All right, we're going back modern. We might go to the 60s.
They're not going to make anything else besides Grand Theft Auto and then now we have Red Dead Revolver 2.
You realize Grand Theft Auto is still a top seller.
Right.
Now, it's still a top seller.
Yeah. Theoretically, I mean, okay, so they put all their eggs in that basket. And then what do they make? Grand Theft Auto 6?
I still have my fingers crossed for Max Payne 4.
Oh, I forgot about that.
Well, I mean, it was Remedy, ultimately, but yeah.
L.A. Noir, which they're not going to make another
one. I heard that game wasn't very good. I never played it.
It was good.
I heard it was good.
It was very good.
What are you talking about?
It was very... I think for people who want more, like, action, a little police games.
Yeah.
But for what it was very good.
You know...
Because you're a detective. But you're being a logical detective. You're not, like, running around just bang, bang, bang. You're actually doing police work, in a way. Like, literally...
They gamify it, yeah.
Yeah, and you're literally looking at people's expressions and being like, alright, are you lying to me? And they're like, ma'am. No, I'm not lying. It's like, you're a lying sack of shit. Tell me the truth. It's really fun. You should give it a shot. At least look at it.
If they give it a remaster, maybe. Well, it probably for PC, huh?
True. Yeah, I think so.
Yeah. But, yeah, you're right. They kind of don't have too much. But they don't have to worry about that, though.
What?
Rockstar.
Oh, yeah.
The product comes out from Rockstar. You know, like, how they talk about, like, in movies, oh, my gosh, like, wasn't it the Wizard? Or the Wiz?
Yeah, I'll say
the Wiz. But they talked about how, you know, they have the Nintendo competition. Like, oh, if a game comes out and it's Nintendo, it's going to be amazing. Now, Nintendo has faltered in some games that have been released. But Rockstar kind of hasn't. They faltered in the sense of, it wasn't amazing, but it's still great. Like,
yeah, like Max Payne, I feel like, falls into that.
I love Max Payne.
You know what?
I was talking about GTA 4. Because I think people didn't love it. Yeah. Vice City, great. San Andreas,
amazing.
Great.
Classic.
My favorite of the series.
San Andreas was a lot of fun. And then you go to 5. 5 was great. I love 5.
But 4 is...
4 is kind of that weird kind of gap where they were trying to... It was a transitional phase. They were growing into other stuff, and it just feels like an empty world, to be honest.
You know what, though? You know what I would like to see Rockstar do again? Bully 2.
Bully 2 might be good.
Bully was great. Bully I always see good. It around. I'm like, I
it's all, it was on sale. It was like $10 or something like that. But I'm like, man, it's gotta be Darksiders too.
Are you still playing that?
Very sparingly.
Why haven't you beaten it? Huh?
Because
you beating that game?
Because I'm not fucking excited about it. I beat Resident Evil the day after it came out.
True. Yeah, I must say, if you're trudging through a game you don't like, it's like the most painful. It's almost like a waste of time.
Pulling my nails, man, with that game. I mean, it's better than the first one, without a doubt.
That was me playing Atelier, Iris.
That one, yeah.
Whatever the farming game. Just so bad.
The thing is that... it's not like a bad game, right? It's just like you just don't like it. Which is actually worse.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Because
I feel like you gotta respect it a little bit.
Yeah.
You just don't want to play.
Right.
What other games are coming out in the next... shortly?
I gotta look
up... Neo comes out next week. I'm picking that up.
Oh, yeah. The, Dark Souls meets Ninja Gaiden?
It's actually... Someone broke it down and said it's more Bloodborne than it is Dark Souls.
Oh, jeez. Oh, really? Alright, go for it.
Well, I mean, there's a difference. Come on, don't act like you weren't there.
I'm just saying, like, it's the... I know what you mean.
A Souls game. Yeah.
No, you know. It's... I'm looking forward to it. I actually checked some reviews on it, and I don't like to check reviews, but I was worried about Resident Evil, so I checked.
I do. I do, too.
That's I checked Resident Evil, and everyone's like, oh my god, it's amazing. And then I went and I checked Neo, and everyone's like, oh my god, it's fucking amazing. So... We'll see.
Was it already out in Japan? Or is it just people that released like it or reviewed it early?
Yeah, reviewed.
Oh, so there's no embargo on this one?
No.
That's good news. That's always a good start.
And it's Tecmo. I'm waiting for the next Ninja Gaiden, so waiting for them to fall back into that. We're gonna fucking beat your ass with this difficulty shit, but you'll love it.
They should make Ninja Gaiden with Rachel as the main character.
You could play her in Sigma. She was. You could play the entire game.
A new one with even better graphics. Even better physics.
There's one with Momoji. Momoji's in 3, I think.
Momoji?
Yeah,
Momoji. I actually don't know much about Ninja Gaiden.
So,
is it how it sounds?
Yeah, Momoji.
I never beat any of them besides the Nintendo.
Ayane is a pivotal character in the second one, I think. You know, it's funny. I don't know if you guys noticed, Ninja Gaiden takes place in the same universe as Dead or Alive.
Yeah.
So during the tournaments, this shit happens.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Like, this is actually happening.
So, wait. So let me get this straight.
The tournaments? I think it's before it'd be all the tournaments.
So much better if it was, like, during the tournaments and Rio Hayabusa is going through this. He's like, he beats the bad guys. Like, all right, I gotta fight somebody. He just runs off. That's how he does his intro.
Yeah.
No, hey, girl.
Momoji's cool.
Who's that?
Momoji.
No, I mean, I can't see it.
She was a character in... she was also... They introduced her in Dead or Alive. I don't like her in Dead or Alive. I think she's shit, but...
Oh, that's her.
Yeah, so she's in...
She's cool looking.
Yeah. I like Rachel a little bit bigger, but... I mean, better. You know? But, no, she's good.
You're weird as ever.
So, Eric, who is not here because apparently he's a little bit sick... But he has requested a topic for the podcast.
I miss you, Eric.
What makes you sad as a gamer?
What makes me sad as a gamer? Oh, I'll start this off. I get sad all the time. losing a game with a team and knowing it's your fault.
Oh, yeah. Like you do in every game that we lose.
No.
In League of Legends.
No, the fuck we don't. Last game. Thanks, buddy. No. I analyzed last night, and not all that's my fucking fault. I got really upset after that. Really upset.
Oh, after what?
After the last couple games.
Didn't we win the last game?
No. We got spanked at the end. Badly. Remember? It was like, but losing games, so just in general, losing games and you feel like you could have done more, done better, and that kind of makes me sad, because... You know, you give it 110%, like, it just wasn't good enough sometimes. You just make some bad plays.
Okay.
What about you, buddy?
You know, Eric sent it, and I already had a response ready. Watching Spencer play. That's what I was going to say, but I was like, you know what? I bag on Spencer too much lately. Even though watching you play Dishonored and Deus Ex just fucking drove me crazy.
Dishonored made me insane. Legit insane watching.
No!
It's been Rachel! I would say, don't go now. Don't move now. And then sometimes like, go! And you're just sitting there. I'm like, come on, please, go. Well,
did you watch when I was... You did watch when I was playing...
Yes, I did. So, okay. Yeah,
Deus Ex?
No. I saw it, but I mean...
I remember you falling down an elevator.
Okay. When I was playing Deus Ex, somebody was watching me, and there was commenting. I can't remember who, but I was playing it. Probably. I was playing towards the very end of the game, the final boss, and I was hiding in a vent.
That was me.
And you fell.
No. Oh, I was hiding in the vent, and I would pop out, and I would shoot him a little bit, and then he'd find me and start shooting the hole, and I would just crawl back in and wait literally like 3 minutes. Right. And then do it repeatedly over and over until I killed him. I was streaming it. It was so bad.
No, you know what drove me crazy? I thought my stream was broken. This is what was happening. I was watching you play Dishonored, and there was a part where you kept getting stuck on, but you save-scummed it. So, like, literally, I kept watching. It was, like, this dark area. You were on, like, a balcony, you remember? And you kept jumping down, and you keep getting caught, and they would kill you, and then you would reload it, and it would happen over and over and over again. I was like, is the screen broken? And I would refresh it, and it would be the same thing. And I was like, what the fuck is going on? And then you would say something different, so I was like, no, this is not Limbo. This is just what's happening.
Yeah, yeah.
I was like, god damn.
I'm not the greatest player, you're right.
No, that's not my reason. My reason, and I'm guilty of it, of doing it to other people, is... getting upset at a game and not, like, kind of analyzing. right? So, like, I'll play Street Fighter. Because Street Fighter, I think I see it the most. I don't get as upset at Street Fighter as I would maybe playing, like, Overwatch, because sometimes it's not, you can't do anything right. You'll be doing everything you're supposed to do. Like, you'll be playing an Ana, 60% accuracy, 70% accuracy, whatever. Team's just not pushing. There's not much you can do. But in Street Fighter, everything's on you. Right. I think losing and not knowing why gets me a lot of times. And understand, I've played a lot of fighting games, so I can generally kind of break it down. But sometimes I'll play it and I'll just be like I have a very A and B mentality. If a guy hits me with an attack, either it's safe or it's not. And if it's safe, he might be able to special cancel into another move. So my opportunity should come after the move is special canceled. That's when I should be looking at doing something.
Right.
But if I'm attacking, or if he's attacking and the move's not safe, I need to consider what I can do to punish it or to change the flow of combat back to my favor. Mm-hmm. Things like that. And in Street Fighter V, it's hard because in games like that, you always want to jump into the game right when it's out so everyone's on the same level.
Right.
So, like, when I was playing Guilty Gear, I was smoking people because I was just like, I've been playing for a minute now. I know what other people's, like, flow charts are. Right. I know how to punish the guys appropriately. And depending on the character, I'm either destroying you or I'm, you know, scraping by. But the character I played, it just worked out that way. But, yeah. Getting upset about it and kind of, like, taking it out is kind of a thing I'm working on. But, yeah.
Yeah, it's the frustration of just not knowing what you did wrong. I know that feeling, too. I just kind of don't give a shit about that, though. How about you, Spence? What makes you upset?
I would say this might sound a little pretentious.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this.
That'll be the show, folks. Let's get out of here.
But when people I potentially care about really enjoy bad games... And by bad games, I mean, like...
Oh, I'm at the care about part.
Well, like, my brother, he goes like, oh, my God. Like, I know you're a gamer. I'm turning into a real gamer myself. I'm like, really? What are you playing? And he said, I'm really into Clash of Clans. And I was like... What? Like, you mean the mobile game?
You know what? I'm the same way, but I'm trying my best to just let that go and be like, okay, you're enjoying games, that's cool. I know what you're saying, go ahead.
It's such a different psychology of gaming. It's like not a game to me. To me. It's not a game if your sole purpose is to pay money. And they always say it like, well, you don't have to spend money.
Right.
It's like, how much money have you spent? Like, a lot of money. And then you go. Because the only way to succeed in those games is to spend money. It's just feeding off of that, like, really weird human desire to achieve in this
it's like the dopamine.
Worthless world.
It's like the dopamine response. That's right. What it is. Yeah. Like, you're getting rewarded for it. That's what I was like with, not me, but what people, when Candy Crush was, like, big.
Yeah.
And people were playing this all the time. And I was just like, and, like, constantly being, like, man, I love games. I love fucking games. And I'm like, what do you play? Candy Crush. And I'm like, okay, that's cool. What else? Oh, that's all I play. And I'm like, you don't love games. You love a game.
It sounds snobby, but like...
Yeah, I know. That's what I was like. I'm like, I'm just going to let it... You know what?
And I should just let it go, but I'm considered in the same demographic on a lot of studies as this.
Right.
As this person that is obsessed with a game that you pay money and you get a response. And you pay more money, and you get a response.
I know what you're saying. I absolutely...
Like, to me, it's not gaming, and it just... It kills me.
Yeah, and that's the worst thing, because the thing is, I still think it is gaming. Yeah. But it's just a different type, and it's just something that we... Not even old school, not even, like, the new age, just people who, like, play console games all the time and actually diversify our portfolio beyond mobile games.
And I'm gonna throw one that if Eric hears this, he's not gonna like it.
Yeah,
but
Pokemon Go.
Yeah, Pokemon Go. I almost classify it into that category. It's somewhere in between, but Like, I get it that people get exercise and stuff from it, and that's great. I think you really need to get your heart rate up before. Like, you should be running from location to location. But the fact that you're walking around is fine. But
you don't have to run to lose weight.
Yeah.
You gotta get your heart up.
Yeah, just heart rate.
You don't have to run to get your heart rate up.
What I'm saying is, if you're not getting your heart rate up, I mean, walking is good, but it's not as...
It's all about the speed. You can walk, whatever.
Yeah. As long as your heart rate gets up, you can lose it, but I don't think walking always gets your heart rate up. At least for me, it doesn't. So, but what I'm saying is, it's great that it does that, but as a game itself, I think a lot of times it falls into that trap of just, like, that constant human response of wanting to progress its something that doesn't really matter. And it doesn't fit into what I like in gaming. And when you look at the gaming demographic, they're like, well, over half of gamers are females, and it's like, I'm not saying there's anything wrong with female gamers, but okay. when you create that, like, that this is the gaming that it is, it's like Candy Crush or like a I don't want to be counted in that demographic.
Well, here's the thing about that, the half of gamers are game, like, it's not, that's not totally true. Like, are you not, I'm not gonna try to put words in your mouth, but please tell me, you're not saying, like, when you count half the gamers as girls, they're playing mobile games primarily. Is that, you're not trying to say that, are you?
No, he is, because that's what they counted.
That's what they counted as.
Yeah, I forgot who actually did it.
This actually, well, yeah.
And I don't like being lumped into that, because we don't have the same interests. So it's like, gamers really like this. And it's like, well, no.
It's like being like, guys really like this.
Mobile gamers really like this.
Football, fans of football will really enjoy blank.
Right, right.
No? No, I'm an individual.
Some fans of football really love Blitz. Like, yeah.
Okay, sure. It's crazy. But is everyone going to love Blitz? No.
People in gaming really enjoy, like, bright colored candy, so they'll say it on like CNN or something. It's people, like, well, I'm not that,
right?
You know, I don't want to be included
people
in that.
People really love Angry Birds, so we should put that on a console, like,
right?
No, why?
It was on a console.
That's what I'm saying. That's exactly what I'm saying. It was on a console,
and you see that, and it's like, this is so dumb. So I that makes me sad, is being lumped in with gamers that you don't necessarily want to be lumped in with.
Well, that's ultimately what you're saying. It's not when your friends or family play shitty shit.
Well, then I just want to strangle them. But
I don't want. Did you hear that?
Good for you.
Good for you. No, I mean, I get that. I had a meeting with my my manager one time, and my manager is great. She's an awesome person, and she was talking to me about. She's like, you know, because normally you're supposed to, like, review, like, how are you doing at the job? She's like, I don't know anything about you. She's like, let's just talk about, and I'm the worst talker, so I was talking forever. And subject came up about gaming, and I brought up this show and stuff like that. And I'm like, yeah, it's like therapy for me. And she was like, we had this long discussion about games, and then afterwards she's like, yeah, you don't really sound like the typical gamer to me. And I'm like... No, I don't. But at the same time, like, I'm not saying there isn't a stereotype for it, because there is.
Yeah.
But, like, you pretty much... The only people that fall into that stereotype are unaware that they're in that stereotype, I feel. Like, it's the guy that listens or reads comic books, the guy that kind of stays in his own world, maybe watches anime, stays in his room, plays games, more excited about the next great game coming out, antisocial... Can't talk to people. Maybe hasn't drank
JD,
beer.
JD, please stop.
But you're here every Saturday, so at the very least, you're social. Yeah.
You know,
like, stuff like that.
I don't really mind the Mountain Dew and Doritos stuff. Like I know that's like a...
Gamer fuel, bro!
Gamer fuel or whatever. I don't mind that. I would rather be labeled as that than a mobile gamer. I prefer that. Because at least it's like... Sort of like it's sort of funny, and it's like kind of a culture, and it's got... things about it that I do like. So I don't know. I don't like mind that. I just don't like being lumped in as a mobile gamer. I refuse to do that.
Do you not like any mobile games, may I ask?
No, I think you do.
There are a couple.
Like Tomb Raider, go.
Yeah,
there are a couple that don't rely on that.
Yeah, I'm going to say, if mobile gaming was just all about just pay for a game and then play the full game, you know what I mean? And, you know, not have all these kind of, like, paywalls, you know what I mean? to get, you know, that stop you from playing.
But question for you, JD. What do you think she meant by you don't seem like a gamer?
Yeah, that's what I was going to ask. What, I mean, that seems like a good topic.
So I was going to get into it, but you cut me off.
Oh, okay.
But ultimately, the I think she she's more mature, right? And by mature, just age-wise.
Okay.
I don't know how old she is. She's obviously older than me. But people tend to have a skewed kind of mentality on a particular, you know, demographic if they haven't experienced it, right? Like, oh, crap, we're in Compton. All the black folk and Mexicans are going to kill me. You know, I don't know, maybe.
Yeah. Will they, though? Yeah.
Oh, we can't go in this neighborhood. It's urban.
I didn't say that.
But so Martin Luther King on the street sign.
But, you know, like, because people aren't experienced to being around that kind of people and they don't right. know that gamers come in all different shapes and sizes, it kind of becomes this thing that people have accepted that it's okay to, like, kind of be like, oh, well, you know, I can make fun of it. Like, you guys have seen, like, Clueless Gamer,
yeah.
Conan, right? Conan's a great guy. I think he's very funny.
I hate that.
He does the Clueless Gamer thing, and he's like, oh, what is this even?
You know, I like stuff that. Like that. It's funny,
he did one with Tom Brady. Obviously in reference or leading up to the Super Bowl, and he did one where ultimately he just, how do you put it, like he was like just feigning ignorance the entire time. And I'm like, I know Conan at least plays some video games, you know, at the very least he plays very probably basic stuff, very minimal stuff, and I'm sure he's had some great Clueless Gamers. They did For Honor, and he was just like, what, huh, what, like he was acting like a YouTuber ultimately, and I'm just like, people really think that's how, like, you know what I mean? Like, the whole moniker, the Clueless Gamer kind of concept is, yeah. Like, because he can't, because he's just jumping in, he can't enjoy the game for, or enjoy the community of it, or, you know, yeah, the game, what it is, whatever the case is. Mm-hmm. I mean, I get it. If you and I walk down a, me and you walk down a hall in a game, and we see something lit, we go, oh, I should probably go towards that. And a guy who's not really into games is probably going, where the fuck do I go?
Mm-hmm.
So we're used to the sort of context kind of clues right. that kind of guide you.
Always run towards the enemies.
Yeah, pretty much. You're fighting through the enemies.
Oh, I thought it was hilarious when Conan was... Not hilarious. I'm using it wrong because I hate that sketch.
Entertaining?
No, I thought it was really dumb when he was doing the Fallout 4 one. He played Fallout 4 and... Like, the beginning of that game was really depressing and sad.
Mm-hmm.
And he kind of must have just completely skipped all that to get to the next part where he could just make fun of the roaches. Like, it just really just irked me. That whole series just really,
I gotta watch this some more. I only watched a few.
And the way he, like, attacks people that make games as, like, nerds and stuff is just so, like, old-fashioned and boring. Like, it's like a...
Oh, man.
It'd be like watching an episode of the Big Bang Theory or something. It's
fuck
like
that show.
Right. It's like we're a bunch of get it, like nerds.
Yeah.
Like, oh, it's a Clueless Gamer. Okay, I'm gonna make fun of the people that play these games and the people that make them, call them nerds, and everyone's gonna laugh at it because, you know, nerds.
I'm gonna, like, get celebrities to do
it's such an antiquated concept.
Yeah. And it's just make fun of what you don't understand.
Yeah. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Like, how am I supposed to kill these these roaches? Like, roaches aren't kill. It's like, well, you just hit them a bunch of times. They got the health bar on it. Just kill it.
Kill it.
Quit talking.
And the thing is, like...
Shut up!
Even without the context of knowing video games, they kind of... A, they give you a tutorial in that game.
Yeah,
B,
yeah.
You can see that they give you visible context with, like, them screeching every time you hit them. And they have, like you said, health bars. So as soon as you see it going lower and lower, it's like... I must be doing something to them, right?
Yeah.
I mean, he's clueless.
I know, that's what I'm saying. That's why I gotta watch that again, because I watched, like, maybe one scene.
I hate it.
I mean, and that's really not to knock it on Clueless Gamer. That's everything, though. Mm-hmm. That's people that... I've seen people... Back when I was playing Street Fighter 4, I would have people that would come over to, like, my barracks room that weren't, like, huge gamer guys, and they'd be like, why do you know what you're doing? Right? Like, I had one guy... I was playing Makoto, and Makoto, I usually sandbag the first round, and I sandbagged and I lost. Okay. And he's like, oh, you're not gonna win the next one, he's got you. And I was just thinking in my head, I'm like no, I know what he does. And I destroyed him. I think I perfected him the next round, and then or the following round, and then the last round, I just beat him convincingly. He's like, oh, why didn't you do that in the first place? And I'm like, well, I'm just building up.
Yeah, I was gonna ask, that was like my biggest question about that. It's like, why do you sandbag? Is it to observe them, or is it to condition them to think that, you know, they're better, or not better, but they kind of figure you out. Okay. That way you can switch up your game real quick.
Well, the one thing that I know that I'm good at when it comes to fighting games is I'm good at conditioning and sort of mix-up stuff. Okay. So, I mean, well, it's ultimately conditioning, but I condition people to think a certain way, and then I exploit the way that I condition them. So if I'm fighting a guy that's blocking all the time, I'm going to throw you 8 times to make you... I'm going to be in a certain situation where I'm going to throw you. And then we're getting that situation again, I'm going to throw you again. And then when we get into that situation again, assuming it happens, right, I'm not going to throw you. I'm going to attack. I'm going to do a move that beats that throw instead. So instead of you trying to throw me, I'm going to hit you with something else.
Yeah.
It works best with a character that has a good overhead. Overhead means while you're crouching and you're blocking, I can hit you still.
Yeah.
Or a good overhead and a throw. That's why Makoto worked. She had the command throw, and she has the Orochi, the overhead chop.
Can we be a little bit more modern in sort of a Street Fighter V in that sense, you know what I mean?
Okay. So
just,
Well, that's fine. When I used to play Laura, Laura's overhead was her V skill, right, where she does that weird little side flip thing, and then she obviously had her throw. But
this dickhead, I'm sorry.
What?
Stop glaring like me down. Knows. Yeah. Go ahead. No. He's just glaring at me. He's pissing me off. Anywho, continue.
But, okay. But that whole conditioning thing is really, it's different for everybody. Some people have different skills. My skill just happens to be conditioning. For someone else, like, I don't know what my brother's is. I think my brother's is being able to read other people. So he can put himself into their, I mean, everyone has those skills. It's just a different.
Your brother, what's my skill, Jamie?
I haven't seen you play fighting game. Well, I mean, I've seen you play Smash, but the thing about Smash is I would have to play Smash a lot to know the underneath kind of thing, like what's going on.
Watching your brother play was pretty interesting because it would be like he would be kind of losing, but then he redirects his tactics like quick.
Yeah, he's like...
It's kind of crazy that you beat him, though.
Well, I mean, everyone's going to lose. It's not like I'm just like destroying them all the time.
Oh, I thought this would happen to 50.
We did the first to 50 and I won. I mean, we played a couple of matches here and there, and yeah, he has beaten me. We've just never done that again.
Wow.
And I don't think he wants to do it again. It's not... Okay. I don't think he likes Street Fighter that much. But I would do a first to 50 on Guilty Gear. I'm probably going to lose. And he must not have remembered this, because I remember this. We played over 300 matches of Dead or Alive. Back when Dead or Alive 5 first came out, and I lost like 80% of those matches.
Wow.
Yeah, I got destroyed. And I didn't get upset. I was just like, yeah, it's not my fucking game. Same thing with Tekken. I got destroyed in Tekken, and I'm just like, not my game. I love Tekken, not my game. We didn't really play in Virtual Fighter. But when it comes to Street Fighter, I have a better idea of what's going on. We're getting off the topic, but ultimately, when I was there sitting in my room and the dude's like, oh, why didn't you do that in the first place? I'm like, well, it's the kind of underneath aspect of it. Like, it's just like if you're playing a sport. That's why I don't understand baseball, but when it comes to basketball or football, sponsorship. When it comes to basketball or football, especially in the case of basketball, someone's going to try and cut up a defense to try and go for a shot. Or
this guy's a shooter. I need to play up a little bit on him.
Yeah, so it's no different. You're still thinking that way. You're just not moving around as much. You're more focused on this. So what are you doing?
No, nothing. I'm just laughing when you talk about basketball with that one-on-one we had. When I was trying to analyze him, I overanalyzed him, and I was like, man, this guy must be good. And all he's doing in the first game is just like bouncing the ball through the three-point line, just like and just back and forth. I was like, this guy doesn't know what the fuck he's doing.
Yeah. I haven't played basketball in like 15 years,
man,
like 10 years.
We went on a serious tangent.
I mean, the Clueless Gamer thing ultimately is where it kind of came into. We don't like the concept of people kind of... It's not your culture, I get it. It's not what you're into, but it doesn't mean that I have to identify as having certain characteristics.
I don't get offended by anything. I don't get offended by that.
Mm-hmm.
It's just like, it's just not funny. It's like really bad humor to assume that I'm like, what is it, the 90s or the 80s where we assume that people like play games or nerds? It seems like the demographic
for that is people who probably wouldn't play games either, you know what I mean? Or at least not like,
yeah.
Yeah, you know, yeah, they don't play games either. Like, it would be for your mom and dad who don't play games anymore, you know what I mean?
Right. And it's really sad because I love Conan.
He's fun.
Especially way back in the day. I used to love when he had the night show or whatever it was.
Yeah, I may have to watch more of those Conan Clueless games so I just have more context of what's going on with that.
Yeah, I mean, well, that's sort of a baseline. The thing that ultimately is kind of weird is when someone goes, you're not that typical gamer. And again, I wasn't offended. The manager's amazing.
I'm just curious what that
assumption is. It's probably something I should be like, well, what do you think it is?
Well, you know, you'd be like, oh, you didn't talk like this, and you didn't smell bad, and
you didn't have a hard time making, because I do remember, she did tell me, she said, you make eye contact with me. And I was like, okay.
Most gamers don't. Most gamers
like this. Well, have you ever met a person that is like the stereotypical gamer?
Yeah.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah.
Doesn't it kind of disappoint you?
No, it doesn't disappoint me. It's just more of like, that's because the thing is they're all over the place.
Right.
You know, that stereotype anyway, mm-hmm. and it doesn't help. So, you know what I mean? Like, people are obviously going to generalize, but when I see them, I don't go like, oh, you pull, so, you know, like, you have a discovered alcohol and titties. Like, yeah. I don't say that. I'm just, it's just more of like a, all right, this person has what they value.
That's right? A good way to
look at it. This is what they value in life, and they're pursuing it, and that's good for them. You know, I'm not the guy that's going to try and tell you that you need to do something else, especially being a gamer. Fucking go outside! You know?
Yeah, yeah.
Well, I do this raid back and forth. Yeah, I'm not going to do that, but
sometimes I think I look at them and I'm just like, you're kind of a dork.
But I also think that's partly the reason why a game like for instance, like Destiny was so popular. Because I bet you, people were looking at that and going, wow, why don't other games have these sort of mechanics in a raid? And you're like, welcome to the show, man.
We've
been doing this shit, you know? And they're like, oh, man, for Vault of Glass, you got to do this. It's really intricate. I'm like, let me show you how you have to do turn 13 on Final Fantasy or how to fight fucking Titan Extreme and not fall off the ledge. Let me tell you how bullshit that is.
I gotta see those raid bosses.
They're great. They're fucking hard.
That's the funny, like, Destiny is so, like, unadvanced as far as MMOs go. You can sort of tell. Like, it's like, it's very, like, people have been doing this for so long, but it's like, it's a first-person shooter, so it's different.
Yeah, that's
but
the thing. Like, I'll be honest, I'm not really good at MMOs. I played, you know, I did WoW, I did some of the harder content, but I struggled hard, real hard. But when I was playing,
Oh, no, go ahead.
But when I was playing Destiny, that was something I was actually good at because, I know how to play FPS. I know how to shoot. And these mechanics came easier to me when it came to doing, like, raids and such. And when I was doing, like, the Vault of Glass for a time, I was like, yeah, this is cool. I'm really good at this, so I like it more. I like it more than typical MMO, so let's keep playing this over and over every week.
and that's the thing is like, people look at this stuff and they go, it's revolutionary, it's groundbreaking. I'm like, it's great and good for people for getting into it and, you know, kind of learning that stuff. But that is just a cusp of gaming. Yeah. And honestly speaking, like, if that's all you see when it comes to gaming or whatever cases, because you have that mentality when you go into like a raid, you're like, okay, this is causing damage to me, so I shouldn't be doing this. In the case of Vault of Glass, when you warp through the portal and you have to pick up the shield, you're like, okay, I don't want to be in the darkness. I need to get the shield, because if I don't get the shield, we're going to fucking die. Right. Better take it back to everyone else so I can hurt the boss.
Right.
Like, that's what you're thinking automatically, but someone else is going, fuck, I just died, what the fuck? You know, and then they're doing that like 8 times, and then they're finally getting an idea on what's going on. But...
Sorry.
But yeah, that's... I'm sorry, what?
I'm just thinking about that raid.
Yeah, but it's just... And I haven't done a single... I didn't even beat Vault of Glass. The first fucking raid I didn't even beat. And I kind of don't care. It's not my kind of... I mean, the game is fun for what it was, but I'm not gonna fucking spend 80 hours on there just to get a better Galahorn or, you know.
Yeah, that's what really killed the game, is that A, you're just doing it to get loot.
That's what kills all MMOs for me.
Yeah, I just realized that's one thing that I don't like about MMOs. I love the journey up to 110, but then doing the raid once or twice, done. I don't want to do it like 150 times, especially in an MMO.
I lose all drive.
Yeah, like, I just realized doing, like, it's like, yeah, I'm 110. Do this quest every day. Fuck you.
Dailies. Like, yeah, they're literally daily. Called dailies. It's so dumb.
No, it's not. It's not it dumb. It's just.
I think it is.
That's, people love that, though. I mean, I get it. You know, you do it, and then you get.
Doing it well.
You're doing it well until you do well in the raid. And, you know, it's just a cup of tea. Let them have it.
Yeah. I mean, it's
just a thing to keep you playing.
Yeah.
It's a thing to keep you playing, but that's kind of no different from a mobile game. It's just I don't have to put in money to do it.
Yeah, you do.
For what?
To keep playing the game.
Okay, if I'm doing a $15 a week thing, is that killing me? Or a month, is that killing me? As opposed to some people who, I mean, and I've talked to Troy about this. Troy has told me he's incredibly lucky with his Brave Exvius kind of like setups. Because he's been getting a lot of the good characters without paying this exuberant amount of money. He said people have put in over like $200 in the making.
You know what's crazy about that? You ever see, so Call of Duty Ghost, or not Ghost, Call of Duty Black Ops 2.
Yeah, you bring it up all the time. About how you have to pay money to get some of the.
Yeah, ones. But just the amount of money they put into it, it's just crazy.
It's ridiculous. I would rather take the 15 a month over that shit.
Just but to it's kind still of the same. It's not the same concept, but it's still similar.
It's not hurting my wallet, man.
As much. Yeah.
Not nearly. The fuck? Not nearly.
And may I ask you, haven't you spent money on Overwatch?
Yeah, I spent a shit ton of money on Overwatch.
Weird.
There's a difference. There's a great game there.
I know. Oh, shit.
The game isn't.
And, plus, you're only getting it for cosmetics. It's not stopping you from getting like the best stuff.
Yeah, there's no progression that's going on with that. And I do it because, like I said, I care about the game.
I care about the company.
I care about the company. Yeah. Blizzard has honestly been there since my fucking childhood.
Yeah, all things considered. Everyone, Diablo and all those games.
They run the SNES, right?
Yeah, they had, Lost Vikings.
Lost Vikings.
Yeah, Lost Vikings was great.
I don't even know what that is.
Yeah, it's like a puzzle game. You have to utilize the Vikings. They all have different abilities. It's like they're in a spaceship, but they're Vikings.
That's crazy. I didn't know that.
Yeah, it's neat stuff. But, I mean, like, even in my childhood, yeah, I liked Blizzard. So, as I've gotten older, I've been like, it's okay if I get
one. I've fallen out with Blizzard a little bit. I like Overwatch. That's great. They nailed that. I don't like what they did with World of Warcraft. I don't like Heroes of the Storm. Diablo. I don't like what they did with Diablo 3, but maybe
if
I went back and played it now, it'd be better. Like, I played it at launch.
I played it at launch, too.
I deleted it.
I played it at launch, and I beat it at launch, and then I stopped playing, and then I waited for the expansion. Expansion dropped, and the game became such a different.
Yeah, maybe it's better now.
I think it became different after the patch, to be honest.
Well, then they started to do things where, like, you could map however what abilities you wanted to whichever button you wanted to, instead of being like, your X has to be this kind of attack.
That's true.
That was the biggest thing that people hated, and they took all that shit out.
Yeah, maybe I'd like it now. I could probably give it a shot now. Because, yeah, back when I played it, like, it might have even been beta, but when I played it, it was just everything I hated with gaming. It's like, I'd rather play with Path of Exile in this.
Mm. Yeah, and Diablo clones were actually really more popular then.
But I hate what they did with World of Warcraft. That's just maybe it's
the end of an era.
But yeah, maybe it's just not even their fault. Maybe it's just there's nowhere else to go with this and it needs to just die.
Yeah.
But I definitely didn't like the casual stuff. As soon as they make these games more casual, I get why they do it, but I don't like it.
So what did you like about before, if I may ask?
What?
What did you like about before? Just so people,
the difficulty, like, you had to achieve things to which they continuously removed the strategies, the difficult, like, it was hard to complete a dungeon. I like that.
Oh yeah, dungeons are a joke. They're just there to kind of
for
just
what?
Be there.
Yeah, dungeons are nothing. I like having to get people together to do it. I don't like Autofinder. I don't like having. I don't like flying. I think that's dumb.
Yeah, even them, Blizzard was talking about that. They were saying, like, how flying kind of broke the game.
Because, yeah. Oh, absolutely.
But then they took it away at later games.
Good.
And especially Wrath of Lich King, he took it away, and then the one before that.
Wrath of Lich King, it wasn't in.
Or not Wrath of Lich King. It wasn't. Warlords of Draenor, that's what I was talking about.
They completely took it away?
They made it very, very hard to get it, and then, what's the last one right now? Golly. What's the name of it? Cataclysm? No. But the last expansion, you don't have it.
Legion.
Yes. You don't have flying at all.
Good. So. Yeah, completely remove it. It's conveniences in these things. Don't listen to the fans. They don't know what they want. They say they know what they want. They don't know what they want. Yeah. Don't listen to them.
Don't listen to their lies.
Yeah. Well, I mean, I don't know. That's kind of stuff that's, like I said, I think it's the end of the era. And I'm actually okay with looking forward because I do, I'm not going to fucking lie, like where Final Fantasy is heading. I think if Final Fantasy got a little bit more like of a push, and hopefully it comes with this expansion, got more of a push, everyone's going to start jumping in. It'll be good for the company because I don't think 14 deserves the flack that like 13 got, and some people didn't like 12. Some people didn't like 11 at all.
I don't know how you would lump 14 next to 13 at all. I don't make that connection.
So it's more in the sense of when they were released.
Oh, okay.
Because they were released at the same, or not the same time, but
around the same
time. Yeah, around the same time. And you're looking at 14 when 14 first came out. Was bad.
I thought that's what really killed it, was that.
And people didn't trust the company.
Yeah, after I 13, sure as hell did.
People didn't trust the company.
I didn't trust Square Enix.
Because they're like, you're not going to deliver a product. 13 was with Lightning.
Yeah, but I'm talking about the company.
Or not Lightning.
Yeah, yeah.
It was. Square Enix. People didn't trust Square Enix.
Why?
Because they made that.
Because they made 13.
Oh, okay.
So, and then when 14 dropped, and it was just kind of more the same shit, the only time, as far as I know, asking people that played since 14, since the beginning, the only time 14 got good was when they were shutting down the servers. Because they had a live event to show it, which was fucking badass. You can watch the video on it. Ultimately, the meteor that you've been working so hard to stop from coming to Eorzea and wrecking the place couldn't be stopped. Mm. And you're watching it fall onto Earth. And that's actually pretty sick. And the music started playing that leads up to the trailer right when they cut off the servers. Mm. And then when they cut off the servers, they showed everyone the new cinematic that no one knew about. They cut it off at the halfway point. And then when they announced A Realm Reborn, they showed you getting teleported 3 years in the future after the meteor landed and everything's kind of coming back. It was a good concept behind it. And then now you're looking at everything and everything's like different. There's more of these, what are they called? Primals, the Guardian Forces, summons. There's more of that shit. There's new threats. It's great. They did a good job of resetting it. And I think that, I honestly think that should still be in the game. Because I thought that was the sickest thing. Was that you see the entire sky was red when you log on that day. And it's just the music is playing. And everyone's just kind of like watching from this mountain. And there's a huge little war going on. And you're just like, fuck, it's over. So, good stuff there. But we'll see what Final Fantasy does.
I would want them to make one that's more lighthearted.
A Final Fantasy?
Yeah.
Final Fantasy's never been crazy lighthearted, though.
I think it has.
They always had really dark undertones.
There's darkness, but I want them to go away from like the really realistic human-looking people.
Okay, play the fucking world of Final Fantasy then, man.
No, not that. Not that way.
You said lighthearted. You said you wanted less
not,
realism.
Not that lighthearted.
I'm hitting 2 for 2, man.
Final Fantasy IX. If they made one that was like that, that'd be sick. I love that world.
I never played that.
IX was okay. I've expressed my concerns about it. He feels differently. Ultimately, I thought some of the characters were memorable. Majority were shit.
But I like that style. And no, they were not shit.
The fucking Nicali guy? You know what I'm talking about? No, you didn't.
I said it on play.
Yeah, I said that joke to Brandon, and he couldn't stop fucking laughing.
He's pretty bad. Quina is pretty bad.
Yeah, fucking. I did not care about Steiner.
I love Steiner.
I thought he was great in combat. I couldn't stand him otherwise.
He was cool.
I didn't really understand the concept behind Kuja, really. I was just like, okay, fine, you're an evil that needs to be stopped, you know? I didn't like Zidane. I liked Zidane at all. I hated him. I liked V.
Did you like Final Fantasy X?
That's what I was going to say. Final Fantasy X was kind of lighthearted.
X wasn't lighthearted. X had some dark shit towards the end.
Yeah, towards the end, but I mean, like, your character's kind of like this surfer dude, kind of goofy. Yeah, he only cares about Blitzball.
But the thing is it fit with the theme. of at least his character fit with the rest of the world that he got.
And he all, yeah, he played.
And then like the twist was nice.
Yeah.
But that's when he got. Yeah, but I mean, but as far as the characters in 10, I liked a majority of the characters more in 10 than I did in 9. I wasn't really a fan of Titus, but Orin was sick, especially the concept behind
it. You know what? Titus, I turned around on. Like, first time I played the game, I completely hated him. I was like, man, you're just a dumbass. But when you really analyze him, he kind of, like, by, like, he's at a 10, he goes to, like, a 30 on 100, but he grows.
He does. You kind of realize his whole thing is he just doesn't want people to be sad. So, like, everyone makes fun of that scene, right? But that's because he's trying to... It's a forced laugh that he's trying to show. I think something bad happened, and he's like, you have to... You can't be that way. You can't stay like that. So, I mean... And ultimately, the twist kind of played into that, being like, oh, hey, this is the type of person that he is. And then... But as far as characters, the only boring characters, I think, were... It was two boring characters. It was Kimimaro, who was just fucking lame. You got rid of him. And then... I don't even think Waka was boring, because Waka and Lulu had a... what's
Pang,
it called?
Pang. Kid?
No, they... Yeah, eventually. But, I mean, they had a real problem with each other, like, traveling with each other. And then...
Oh,
yeah. Riku, I'd probably say, wasn't really all that developed.
Riku... Or Waka had a real problem with Riku.
No, Waka and Lulu, because they used to fuck. That's why. Orin was neat. Yuna was boring to me in 10. In 10-2, she's better, but in 10, she's like, Umiga TV, and it got fucking old so quick.
Someone described her real well. It's just the Japanese, like, anime prince.
She's an anime, yeah. No, yeah, that's right. So, I mean, it's whatever. Every fucking Final Fantasy has some sort of trope. It's just, which ones are they going to get away with and which ones aren't they? I'm a soldier.
I like 9.
yeah, whatever. I mean, Zodiac Age is coming out, so I'll be able to actually...
Zodiac Age? What's that?
Yeah, Final Fantasy 12.
Oh, right. Comes out in,
like, May or June or something like that. So I'll play through that one.
Ugh.
I actually want to play 10 again. And
I've tried to play that again.
Have you tried 10 too?
No.
10-2 is great.
What?
Because it had... Are you fucking kidding me? The active battle system on 10-2 is... You actually feel like you're fucking there as opposed to 10, which is everyone's lined up. And 10-2, everyone's sort of split. You have the dress sphere thing. So, yeah, it's kind of stupid.
I think you would like it, though, because it's very lighthearted.
10-2 is... It starts off, you're at a concert.
Yeah.
Yuna's singing. Come on, dude.
Yeah, and not only that...
I say that, but I did like Tokyo Mirage Sessions. Quite a bit.
Yeah.
There might be hope for this.
It's like, no, that sounds... Oh, wait. But...
I don't know.
Yeah, you may like it. You know, the whole... They show, well, I'm not sure if it's even a spoiler, so I won't say it, but... There's something there for you.
All right. I'm Spencer.
Jetty.
And I'm Rosie.
And this is The Itch. Thanks for watching.
Bye.